Hi everyone, I'm Stephen King from Boltight. In this video, I will showcase the Boltight hydraulic nut. Hydraulic nuts are permanent replacements for standard nuts and remain on the application after tensioning. These tensioners are ideal for applications in confined spaces. I will also show you step-by-step how to correctly install and remove these hydraulic tensioners. So come follow me to the training room. We've got two different types of hydraulic nuts installed on here, and it's our two most popular types of hydraulic nuts. Our most popular hydraulic nut's gonna be the top collar hydraulic nut here. We sell it probably 80% of the time, and then the rest of the time, our other option is a bottom collar hydraulic nut here. And the biggest difference between the two, other than the fact that this one's a bottom collar and this one's a top collar, is that this one right here does really well in pockets. So when you've got a hole that's down, recessed a little bit, this fits down in there and you can still have access to the collar here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna load one of these up right now and show you how to operate it. And then in a minute, we'll do all of them together to show you what this is. Now, just a reminder, these hydraulic nuts are permanent. Like, so it's a permanent solution. So you'll replace a standard nut. And what you would do is just take the nut off and simply screw the hydraulic nut down on there. And the only thing to be really positive, like you've got to be sure of, is you've got a little bit of stud sticking out of the top here. You want at least two threads sticking out of the top to make sure you get a good grab. So just like the TSRs, we're going to use a Tommy bar to turn the collar down. So I'm going to hook up our single hose here to this top collar nut and make sure we lock the collar so the hose doesn't come off. All right, go ahead and pressurize. As we come up on the tensioner, you're gonna see a gap start to open up here, and that's the piston stretching the stud. What you wanna be careful to look for is a red line, the overstroke line. So very similar to what you would see on a TSR Plus or T-Series tensioner, is there's gonna be a red overstroke line. You wanna make sure you don't hit that. So now we've got it pressurized, the stud is stretched. We're just gonna spin the collar down by hand till it's snug, and then we're gonna put the Tommy bar in there and turn it. Just like the sockets on the TSR Pluses, you don't want to put too much load on it. So you just need to snug it up like that and you're good to go. So it's nice and locked. And when we release the pressure, the load's transferred into the stud, the hose is loose, and we're good to go. We just take the hose off, put the cap on, and we can move on to the next one. On a flange, typically we would do 100% coverage. But we wanted to show you one by itself, just so you know you can do them one at a time. But typically on a flange, you would do all 100% at once. So just to show you guys, we can link these up in series. So we're going to take our interconnect hoses and hook them up one at a time to each of the heads. There we go. And there's a couple of different ways we can do this. We could use a T-block or we could use a deadhead style. So we're going to do it deadhead style. So we're going to use one less interconnecting hose and just finish off on the last one. So I've got my first one. We're going to tie this into the second one right here. Lock the collar. We're going to take our third one, turn it around here, hook that up, lock it in. And on my last one, we're just going to finish off right here on the fourth one. And we're going to lock it. We're going to grab our lead hose and hook it up to our first one here. Lock that in place. All right. And there we are. We got all four in series there. And when we pressurize it, all of the nuts will pressure up at one time. And again, you'll just come in and tighten the collars to lock them down, and then you're set. Now that we've showed you how to hook the tensioners up and how to tighten the hydraulic nuts, what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you how to remove them. It's quite simple, it's the reverse of the way we went on. So we're gonna take our hose and we're gonna hook it up to our tensioner that's locked on. Make sure you lock the collar on your hose there. And as we come up on the pressure, we're gonna put a little bit of reverse pressure on this collar. And as it gets close to the pressure that you tightened it at, it should start to come loose. See, right there, broke loose. Now once you get it broken loose, you just wanna back the collar off so that when it relaxes, it doesn't lock down again. So go ahead and release. All right, there we go. Now the nut's loose and I can turn it with my hand. And then we'd simply do that all the way around the flange. We come off the nuts and pull all the bolts out and do whatever work you need to do after that. A hydraulic nut incorporates its own internal hydraulic jack, which enables large diameter bolts to be tensioned to high and accurate preloads. They are quick to install using a hydraulic pump, which activates the internal jacking system. The effort required to tighten a very large diameter bolt is reduced to the effort needed to operate the hand pump. And if an electric or air pump is used, the tightening process is even quicker. As there is no rotation during tightening a hydraulic nut, the operation can be performed in a confined space and torsional stresses or thread damage are eliminated. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful.